pull the belly in, pull the shoulders down. And even here, imagine that glass of water balancing on the crown of your head. And let's picture that vertebrae, nice and long, sits bones pressing down, and shoulder rolls. Right ear to right shoulder. Drop it center, other side. Roll it half moon to the other side. And then half moon to the other side. Feel a nice stretch in the back of your neck. Other side, last time. Back to chin to chest and rise. And then come over onto your back. You've got a knee squeeze on the right. Lengthen your left leg and stay. If you'd like, you can pick up your left leg and stretch it hovering off the mat. I'm just gonna change the playlist. You have 30 seconds here. So knee hug and the leg is straight and hovering off the floor. Let me put some nice chill music on for us. And breathe. In for four count breaths. All the way to the belly and out for four count. I don't know this playlist, so it might be very yogi. You can get all zen. And release and change legs. Left knee in, an option to hover the leg off the floor. Feel like you're hovering it and stamping your foot to the front wall. 30 seconds. Should be having a nice flat back here. Pull your belly down into the lower back. And breathe. Beautiful. Bring that right foot, bent leg down and give me figure four stretch. Push the inside left thigh away. Feel a little stretch on the outside of your hip and just stay there for two breaths. Slowly make your way out of there. Let's do the other side. Cross it over, hand to the inside of the thigh and gently push it away. You should feel that on the seat and the outside of the hip area. Send those feet knee width, hip width, and bridge up for a second. Try to just open the rib cage and expand the front body. No effort there, no squeezing the butt and trying to drive the hips too high. Open, breathe into them here like gills. And then slowly down with the back. And then bring your right knee in and stretch the leg fully to the sky. You can stay with your head down or you can reach to the calf and pull it in a little closer. Still drive the belly down, keep that back really printed in. And let's let the leg go to the front and back here eight times. Eight. Gentle pull in to be kind. Seven. And hold it in on one. Love it on the inside. Ankle circles. Keep a hold of the hamstring if you can. hand, interlace your hands, drive your leg forward into your hands and resist your leg, and then see if you can keep it there and stretch out your left one. So that's a flexibility thing, so not for everybody in this stretch. But still keep pushing your hands into your hamstring and your hamstring into your hands. And breathe in for four. And out. And back into your chest. That was a pretty intense hamstring stretch. Make sure you feel okay. Stretching out that leg. Left knee in. Put your right foot down and stretch. Option to lift your head, neck and shoulders and walk your hands up your leg. Pull your belly down nice and firm to the back, to the floor, and let it go 8 times.
Accepting the outside, clearing all the inside and accepting the outside.
Four.
Clearing all the inside and accepting the outside.
In and hold. And lower your head down, do some ankle circles. And other direction. Interlace your fingers, take them behind your hamstring. Resist into the leg, resist your leg into the hands. And see if you can maintain the leg and stretch out the right one.
Shining on the inside and shining on the outside.
My leg is shaking. So it's definitely a powerful hamstring stretch. In for four count breath. And out. Beautiful. Bring that leg back in, bend, put the foot down, and let's go back to the bridge. Press your arms down, lift your hips up. Really press your arms down, like they're anchoring and trying to melt into the mat. And this is not your bar bridge. You can open up the rib cage. You can arch your lower back and just breathe in for four. Fill up the front of the body and exhale. And slowly come down, flat shoulders, bra strap, sacrum. And then hug your knees and rock forward. Beautiful. Take your feet out to the width of the mat. Hands behind you and windshield wiper. Hold it to one side for a second. Just hold it. And other side. Just hold it. Other side, and turn all the way to that Z stretch. So wiggle your knee in front of your hip. You can see my shin is parallel to the long front edge of my mat, and then match the shape in the back leg. So your hip is nice and flat here, your knee is to the side, your ankle is behind, and fold forward. Give me those nice elbows to the sky and be on your fingertips, and then round up. Flat back down and round up. And now use your breath. 30 seconds. Pushing your front leg down like it's trying to leave that L-shaped shape in the floor. One more time, and we're gonna land it with a forward fold. So come down and stay. Maybe bring the elbow breath out. So your heart should be directly on top of your front knee. Feeling a sensation on that front leg, all the way to the booty, the hip. And then slowly come up to straight arms, walk it up. You can flip to the other side if you want. I'm gonna swing around so I'm facing you. But again, your hip is in behind your knee. Your leg is nice L-shaped and the back leg is an L-shape too. Ankle behind knee, foot is flexed. Bring those fingertips like tripods. And when you're ready, down and round up. There is not a wrong way to do this, just move. And get your back to feel like a flexible, fluid wave. Close your eyes. Two more times. One more wave. And then come forward and hold. Again, if you like, you can bring your elbows down, or you can walk your hands straight out in front of your shoulders. Whew. This side for me is talking to me, it's very tight. Breathe. Keep trying to press your front knee down like you're squeezing a lemon under your front knee. And slowly walk your hands back up again. Oh, awesome job. Bring those knees in. Let's meet in all fours. We're going for some lovely hip circles. So on all fours, gonna lift your right leg up. Very slow fire hydrant. Out to the right, back to donkey, and down and around. And that's the pace I want you to go. Like you're moving in molasses. So you're hitting 3 points. You're hitting to the side, to the back, and then the knees come together. And just breathe. As the song says. You're working, obviously, your femur bone in your hip socket mindfully. One more time. And come on down. Sit back on your heels for a second. So think of this part of class being like lubrication for your joints. When you're ready, come back up again. Nice and slow, left side fire hydrant, left side donkey, and down and around. That pace, please. Feel like you're tracing a clock, giving me all those circle plot spots on a clock. Halfway. One more time. And sit back on your heels. Awesome job. We're gonna work on our hip flexors next, which I know Susie's been talking about hip flexors. Grab your block if you have one. Meet me in a plank. and you're going to bring your right foot all the way between those blocks, between your hands, and then lower your back knee. And then walk your foot out to the side on the right, put your blocks down. Any height, and then put your elbows down. I'm gonna go a little bit higher with my blocks, because I was rounding my back. So as best you can, try not to hunch over. And if you feel like you're still hunching, ditch the blocks and just use your fingertips. You're working on trying to sink this hip towards the floor. And just breathe. Try to squeeze your seat. So you're still kind of being active. If you do get really comfortable, you can come back to those blocks. Give me one more round of breath. In four. Out for four. And then come back up to straight arms. Move the blocks out of the way and reach over to the opposite corner of your front foot. Try to organically let your knee open out to the side without forcing it. And just breathe. Should be feeling some tight spots. Breathe into them. Send them love, recovery. And then walk back safely to the middle of your mat. And then push yourself up and bring that leg back. Oh, how are we doing? That was pretty intense. Let's do the other side. Plank. Left foot forward. And come on down. Walk it out to the side. So again, your hands are on the inside, your arms are straight. Feel like you're bringing your sternum to the front of the mat there. Good 30 seconds. If you have your blocks and you think you can come down to the forearms, any height that you can balance. And both sides are never usually the same. So this side is feeling pretty easy for me. So observe it. Keep your bottom squeezing, that tailbone pushing towards the knee on the floor. And move the blocks out of the way. Go to the opposite corner of your foot. Let that knee just open organically. No effort there, no strain, but an inner thigh stretch. Try to draw the shoulders out of your ears. Walk it back slowly. Beautiful. Bring that leg back. Sit back for child's pose. Stretch the hands forward. If you can feel like you're driving the palms into the mat and pulling the mat towards you, get that nice stretch in your shoulders, scapulas pulling down your back body. and then slide forward. You can do it kind of like a snake. You can snake your body all the way forward and then roll over to your side for a side lying upper quad stretch. So catch that foot. Again, you've got a nice straight hip flexor here. Your knee is going out to the side. Little bonus pec stretch and shoulder stretch there. Keep your core engaged to protect your lower back so you're not going into a little back bend at your lower back. If you have visual of your knee, check it's in line with your hip. And squeeze your booty. You've got 30 more seconds here. Curious to see how close you can go with the heel to the seat. You ever get any pinching or anything that's not safe feeling, obviously back out of it. And very slowly release. And come to the other side. I'm swinging around so I don't have to have my back to you. Tighten up your core, tighten up your seat, and just breathe. Can you make any changes? Can you lengthen your knee longer? And you bring the heel a little closer. And gently release, meet me on your back. Roll over. Take your knees in for a nice tight knee squeeze. And we're going to bring those legs all the way over to the right. Arms to the side. Keep your knees in tight and drop them to the right. Option to look over your left hand. Take your right hand on top of your thigh and deeper. And breathe in for four, out, one more round, in, out, release your hand, bring your knees in back to the chest, and other side. Two rounds of your 4 second breath. Leg, come back. Send your leg straight out. Let them be completely relaxed. Palms up to the sky, rest your hands by your sides. And if you have time for 10 breaths, that would be amazing. I'm gonna stay with you for the 10 breaths. And then if you have any longer, I'll leave the playlist. Get comfortable and just breathe. Thank you. Let your body do zero effort in the breathing. Breathe normally. Feel the support of the floor. You're making zero effort and you're melting. Leave the playlist on for another few minutes. If you have time, just let that body relax, sink down into the floor, and I will see you back on the mat when you're ready. I'd love your feedback. Namaste, beautifuls. Please stay and enjoy.